Hello and welcome to Herodov.com. Today I will present to you the JXD handheld emulating system. This is the box. It's not in very good shape, but the console inside is actually brand new. It has been replaced. So there are some. There's a Wi-Fi direct fighting. What the fuck is this? I don't know. Never mind. Let's open the box and see what's inside. USB cable. This is actually mini USB cable, not micro USB. The charger. You can only charge the console with this charger, not with the USB. No, maybe you can. I don't know. I charge it with this. There are some instructions. It's in Bulgarian. It's percached in Bulgaria. The console itself is percached in Bulgaria, but it's made in Hong Kong. So there's the instructions, as I said, in Bulgarian. So this is the handheld itself. It's a very, very good and very capable device if you're into old school gaming. It's designed to look like a PSP because that's the best shape for a handheld game. It has a analog stick, variable buttons. You can use the console without the touch screen if you break it or something like that. The touchscreen itself, it's not very responsive, but you don't need it to be. The console comes with pre-installed emulators, but I've removed them and installed my personal emulators, my personal favorite emulators. There's a MAME Reloaded and MAME for Droid, one of my favorite emulators. Let's try MAME for Droid. There's a, let's see, let's run Black Tiger. Let's boost the volume. It runs very smooth, very nice. It got this this console has a 1 gigahertz processor, 500 megabytes of RAM. I don't know about the GPU. It's Mali perhaps or something like that. As you can see, the game runs very, very well. No frame drop. And it's very, very comfortable to play with physical controls, especially for old school gaming. So let's try something else. Let's exit this emulator and try perhaps a Genesis emulator. This is the MD.emu, a very, very good emulator which includes cheats for some of the games. Let's see. Alien Storm. As you can see, the game runs very, very well. No frame drops again or lag of any kind. You can use the analog stick also, if you like. What makes this handheld good for games? Even better than Sony Xperia Play, yeah, that was what it was called, is that you can map the controls to any game you want. If you like to play Dungeon Hunter and the game is not compatible with physical controls, for example Dungeon Hunter 2, you can. There's a software inside this console which allows you to map controls, touch controls, to the physical controls. That's something that's very, 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 very good. The game, the screen of the handheld is not very, very good. The resolution is very low, but if you like old school games, that's not a problem because the old school games don't have very good resolution. So, for old school gaming, this is the NES emulator, by the way. For old school gaming, this device is very, very good, and it's very, very cheap, if you can find it, of course. It also got a camera and a microphone, so you can use it with Skype. It has a HDMI. You can plug it into your TV. Headphones, volume up, volume down, menu button, back button, start and select. So let's try maybe another emulator. I don't have games in Android games in this device because I don't feel the need to play them here. I got this for emulators only, and it runs very, very good. Most of the old school games, you know, like Altered Beast, Golden Axe, Black Tiger, or Ghosts and Goblins, run very, very good on this device. You can play Neo Geo, of course. And one of my favorite games, Metal Slug. Let's see if we can find it. Which is a very demanding game, but the console can manage to play it very well. So it's loading and buffering. Oh no, decrypting. And the game will come out just any minute. Come on. Oh, good. This is Neo Geo emulator, so it's like you have a Neo Geo console. There are 5 credits for each game. There's no infinity continue. Very loud, so let's quiet it down. As you can see, Metal Slug 3, which is a very demanding game, if you play it with this emulator, neo.emu, the game runs flawlessly. Of course, there are cheats. You can add infinity time, lives, bombs, and you can play it and enjoy this very, very, very beautiful game. So that's about it. As I said, the console is very cheap. The screen is not good as screen resolution or responsiveness, but it's very, very good for games, very good for old school games. Or if you're into old school gaming and you don't want to buy something that is $200 or $400, like Canoe, for example, which in eBay it costs for about $500. The Canoe is slower and worse than this, and this is only $40. So if you're into old school gaming, go and buy one of these. Thank you, that was all for today. And subscribe to Hirudo.com.